Welcome to my channel.
Hi guys, welcome back. So today I'm gonna talk to you about something that has made such a huge impact in my marriage, and it's praying over my spouse every morning. Praying for your spouse is super important. Chris and I have experienced so much transformation individually and also together in our marriage. We take the time together every morning to pray over each other, and we've developed this into a habit that we do every single day. We don't feel rushed going into our day. We feel connected to each other first thing in the morning. This is our most important routine and personally our most important time of the day. You really want to make this a fun tradition that you guys have together in the morning. So the way that Chris and I do that is we both make each other a cup of coffee in the morning, and we find our favorite spot in our apartment, out on our balcony, on our couch, or in our bed to just sit. If you make it a really fun routine and a fun habit, it's gonna be easier to keep doing. All right, let's get started. So first things first, the first thing that you wanna do is thank God for your spouse. It's really important to be specific. This is gonna really encourage them. It's gonna make them feel uplifted. This reminds you of all the amazing things about your spouse. It reminds your spouse why they're amazing. This is especially helpful if you've been getting on each other's nerves. This is really gonna help out. Number two, pray for this day. So what does your spouse have before them this day that they're nervous about, worried about, anxious about? What are they excited about? If they're about to just have another normal day, then pray for them that it's an exciting day. Pray for their commute, pray for protection, pray for their mind, pray for peace, pray for God's presence over them. Whatever you can think of, just pray for their day, pray for anything. The third thing to pray for over your spouse in the morning, pray for their dreams and pray for their goals. It's super important not just to encourage them verbally, but to pray over them in these areas. Your spouse needs encouragement for the things that they're trying to accomplish in their life. My husband plays rugby. That's one of the dreams that he's always had for his life. We finally decided to start praying over those dreams and goals that he has for rugby. And on his birthday, he got a call from the team that he's been wanting to play for a really long time, and they invited him back to come train with them. Praying over your dreams and your spouse's dreams really does make a difference. The fourth thing to pray for over your spouse is to pray for wisdom. Your spouse is gonna make 100 decisions today, so just pray for wisdom over them to make the right choices, the right decisions. Simple. So the fifth thing that you might wanna pray for your spouse about is pray for their emotions or pray for their thoughts. Ask specifics about what they've been feeling, like super specifics. Are you depressed? Are you anxious? Are you nervous? Are you happy? If they're feeling depressed, Jesus, thank you that you just lift depression off of them. If they're feeling anxious, Jesus, thank you that you just pour out your peace on them. If they're feeling heaviness, God, thank you that you just lift their burdens right now. So, story time. The other day, Chris and I got into an argument while we were decorating our tree. I really wanted to start fun new traditions. It's Christmas season, it's our first Christmas together, and I had a list of things I wanted to do. He was really distracted, he was checking his email, he was on his phone. I was pissed. Instead of talking to him like a normal wife, I decided to freak out on him. All you ever do is work. You're being so selfish. You don't even realize how much this means to me. And on and on and on and on. When I finally asked him what was wrong, he told me he had been feeling depressed and anxious. I totally missed that because I didn't even ask. I just assumed that all was well, and it wasn't. After that discussion, after that argument, I prayed for him, and he said he has not felt depressed or heavy or anxious since then. Last thing, number six, ask God to bless your marriage. I'm sure your marriage is already blessed, I'm sure you're already experiencing good things, but this has been really important in our life because the things that we didn't even think to pray over, God has provided just by us simply asking, will you bless us? Will you bless our friendship? Will you bless our laughter? Will you bless our evenings together? Will you bless our mornings together? Will you bless our conversations? He's touched every part of our lives, every part of our marriage, every part of the nuances of our days, just because we take the time and we really ask God, bless us however you want to bless us. So another helpful tip that's really been beneficial for Chris and I is that I had him write out a list for me to pray over, and I wrote out a list for him to pray over. Writing out a list has really helped us get into the groove of what to pray for. Every month or every few weeks, we write a new list and we give it to each other. We were able to pray over the things that we both really needed prayer for and move on with our day. So ever since the morning after our wedding, we've been doing this. The benefits and the breakthrough in our relationship has been amazing. We've seen so many answered prayers from doing this together, and not to mention there's been so much trust and vulnerability that has grown between the both of us. So this is not a conclusive list. Obviously, you can cut a bunch of stuff out, you can add a bunch of stuff in. Depending on how much time you guys have together in the morning, this is gonna change for you. These are just some ideas for you to get started. These are some tips and tricks that we used for our daily habit of praying over each other. Just use these as guidelines to help get you started. So there you have it, guys. Those are my six tips to help you pray over your spouse every morning. Thanks for being a part of this. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for being you. Thanks for being cool. Thanks for being supportive. Now go share your prayer request with your husband or your wife, and I'll see you in the next video. You can like and subscribe if you want, but I'm getting all done up on back now. Till next time. Mwah. Bye. latte. Hope this will help with our flash marinade. Love you all. Until next time. Bye.